I gotta tell you this story. In 1983, I boxed for the junior championship of the world. And when I boxed, the first guy I boxed was the American guy. And I beat him pretty easy because the American team had one of the best teams next to the Cuban team. Cuban team was there too. So I beat the American, then the Cuban I was supposed to fight. Something happened to his hand, he broke his hand, and they said he couldn't fight me. So I was happy that I won this tournament and everything, and then all of a sudden, a couple of the American guys said, well, he didn't box the best guy on the team. I said, well, who's the best guy on the team? He said, well, he couldn't come, his trainer wouldn't allow him to fly, his trainer doesn't want to fly. So me and my trainer, Arnie Beam, said, who is this guy? Well, he lives up in Catskills. So I said, well, who is he? Didn't know him. We heard he was an animal. Everybody that went up there left and knocked everybody out. So I didn't feel like a world champion at that time. So me and my trainer said, we gotta find this guy. So we drove up all the way to the Catskills. And when we went up to the Catskills, Razor Ruddock was up there. And I said, Razor, how was it? He said, I don't know. And I said, did you spar with him? He said, nope. And then I asked everybody, well, why did Razor leave? Razor left because he didn't want to spar with Mike Tyson. I said, whoa, who is this guy? So anyway, me and Mike Tyson met, lovely guy, brought me into his room, showed me some old fight footage on this backdrop of a white sheet, and he showed me boxes I've never seen before. And he told me all about how the different techniques of fighting and how this, he was really educated on old fighters, and I was saying, this guy's a remarkable, interesting guy. Anyway, the next day, me and Mike Tyson jumped into the ring together. And, you know, I went up there because I wanted to learn and, you know, box. I'm into boxing. And when he came out, he's into, like, trying to knock my head off. So I did my Muhammad Ali thing at the time, and I was like, I was really just protecting myself, but he was coming like a whirlwind, throwing hooks left, right. Man, the first day was rough. Then I realized it's not where you're from, it's where you're at. Anyway, we sparred for a couple of days, and it got easier after a while, a little better. Then there was one time, the last day that we sparred, you know, I was running around like Muhammad Ali again, and Mike Tyson was like, you know, he didn't want me to run around, so he put his hands down, and I went boop, boop. And then all I could hear is, Mike, don't do that! You're gonna fight that guy someday! Turned around, because the model said that. So that was always living in my mind, whether we were gonna fight or not. Anyway, history went down, time went along, and I didn't know if this fight was ever gonna happen. I wanted this fight to happen because, you know, we're the best in our era. People deserve to know who the best fighter is in this era. So, fight finally came around. Now, before the fight came around, I was preparing for Mike Tyson because while I was amateur, Mike Tyson was knocking everybody out on TV. In fact, he looked like a giant on TV. And, you know, I was saying to myself, man, this guy looks like a giant. But we finally fought, which is necessary because when you look at this sport, we're gladiators. You know, this is what we want to do. We want to prove that we're the best. We want to prove that we're the best against the best. And if there's somebody out there that can beat us, we want to know, well, how, why? What is this? Who is this man? And that was me. Very important to do. And I would say, I learned a lot going up there to spar with Mike Tyson. I learned that, yo, this sport ain't for jokers. It separates the men from the boys. Mm-hmm. And it's not about friendship. It's about like knocking somebody out, getting rid of them, imposing your will on them. Very important. So in my life, I would say there's like a lot of different situations that have really helped me become who I am.